Hi everyone, this is Mike from Hummingbot, and this is the second video in our Market Maker training series. Today's topic is picking the right market or market selection. So Hummingbot is an open source project that allows anyone to become an algo trader in crypto. It's open source, it's free, and all the code is available on GitHub. In addition, we have a vibrant community of developers and traders that are contributing to the open source code base. But what we found is that when users first use our software, a lot of them just download it, go through the quick start guide, and just start market making immediately. And we feel like that's probably a mistake. And the reason is because market making is a competitive sport. You're not just competing against the market. There's also other market makers out there that you're competing with. Some of these are professionals as well as individuals. And so if you go into it unprepared, you're likely to lose money. But if you do pick the right market, it's like being in pole position. It gives you an advantage that skews the odds in your favor. So when we talk about market selection, there's three things that we believe people should take into account. The first is how large the opportunity is, which is measured by spread times volume. The second is we think users should take into account the size of the market. So picking the right size, not too big, not too small, is important. And finally, you should take into account the fees charged on the maker side versus taker side, and also what incentives are available for makers. So by spread times volume, what we mean is that the spread, which is the distance between your highest buy price and the lowest sell price, that spread is really where your source of income is as a market maker, because you want to buy low and sell high. Now, how much money you make is driven by volume. So the more traders there are in the market, the more volume there is, the more money you make. And so that's why the classic definition of profitability in market making is spread times volume. But the one thing here is that because volume is so large at the biggest exchanges, if you look at Binance, these guys have $4 billion a day in volume. Huobi also has $3 billion. And so these are much larger numbers than some of the smaller exchanges. And so if you just kind of apply spread times volume naively, it's going to push you into market making for the most active pairs. But what we found is for individual users, some of the smaller markets may actually be better because the large markets is where the professional market makers play. These guys have very sophisticated algorithms. They have tons of capital. And they're also paying much lower fees because they have VIP status at the exchanges. So as an individual, you're probably better off playing in a smaller market. So either an altcoin market on the largest exchanges or like the Bitcoin market in a smaller exchange. Because you'll face less competition, the spreads are wider, and usually there's still enough volume for individuals to make a decent amount of money with smaller capital amounts. And Hummingbot, this is why we not only support the largest exchanges, Hummingbot, but we also, because it's an open source project, we allow kind of anyone to kind of build a connector onto us. So here are the ones in this top list we support. And there's also a number of smaller exchanges we support as well. But even within there, I think another way you can, another tool you can use to find good markets is CoinGecko. And CoinGecko has a couple columns I really like in their data. The first is spread. So they show you the spread for each market. They also have columns for plus 2% depth and minus 2% depth. And what this represents is how much capital is sitting on the order book within 2% of the mid price. And so it's a good estimation of how much competition you'll face from other market makers if you're market making in that market. And so you can see there's a pretty big difference even in the Bitcoin USDT pair for liquidity across different exchanges. Binance, there's 1.8 million of orders, above mid price, and then there's 1.4 within 2% below the mid price. But some of these other exchanges have much less, much less competition. However, some of these exchanges may not be very reputable ones. So please use caution when picking the right exchange. Another thing you can do is look at altcoins on the most active exchanges. Because even though if you look at Bitcoin here, it's a very liquid market on Binance with almost 4 million of liquidity, you know, within 2% of the order price, of the mid price. But an altcoin like Solana, you know, even the most active pair on Binance only has about $20,000, you know, of competition within 2%. So this is a good sign that a market like Solana, you'll face less competition, and therefore in this market may be more appropriate for individual market makers with smaller balance sheets. And the third thing that you want to take into account are fees. So this is the fee schedule for Coinbase Pro. Basically, the taker fees are the fees that normal traders would pay when they just trade. And then maker fees are the fees that market makers pay when we place orders on the books and those orders are then filled. What's interesting about Coinbase is that the fees are pretty high, but they go down very dramatically at large capital amounts. But this is actually bad for individuals because for those of us with, you know, not a lot of money, we're paying, you know, these kind of fees up here. But for hedge funds, they're paying, you know, these kind of fees. So on the maker side, you know, there's a 50 basis points difference between the fees that you're paying versus the fees that hedge funds are paying when they market make on Coinbase. On the other hand, if you look at Binance's overall fees are lower. So their base fees are 10 basis points, maker and taker, and they drop down to 7.5 basis points if you pay with BNB. And so here, the difference between the individual, like the highest level and the lowest level, is much smaller. So on the maker side, there's an 8 basis point difference, and there's only a 6 basis point difference if you pay with BNB. And so that's why in Binance, I think the opportunity for individuals is greater because there's a much less difference, there's much lower difference in fees between what you're paying versus other professional market makers in that same venue. And finally, incentives are a big part as well. So at Hummingbot, we rolled out a program called Hummingbot Miner, which rewards anyone to market make for specific pairs. So far, it's just running on Binance. And so you can see that the rewards per day column shows you how much in rewards we pay out on a daily basis to market makers. Now, these rewards may not cover, may not be the source of profit by themselves, but we have found that they do generally cover fees paid. And so they're a bit of a carrot for you to market make in these markets. And we feel like we have seen that they do help users achieve profitability in certain cases. So those are some considerations you should think about when you're picking a market. So to recap, I think the basic equation is spread times volume. But then after that, I think picking the right market is good. So not too big, but also not too small. And then finally, knowing what fees you're paying versus what other market makers are paying is a good way to think about kind of like competition and where you want to compete and where you don't. So that's hopefully helpful for you guys. And if you have any questions, please let us know in the comments. Thank you.